I raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemies. I raise a hallelujah, yeah, louder than my unbelief. I raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. I raise a hallelujah. Oh, heaven comes to fight for me. Come on, sing. I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm. Louder and louder, hear my praises roar. Come on, say, I raise a hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Thank you for joining us for another Bible study here at Victorious Word Christian Center. We thank you, Lord, for joining us on our YouTube channel, Victorious Word Christian Center. And I just want to let you know we appreciate you joining us on today. And as we go, before we go into our lesson, we want to pray. Father God, we thank you right now. We praise your name. We bless your mighty name, for you alone are worthy. You're worthy of all praise, honor, and glory. We glorify the name of Jesus. We exalt your name, God, because you are the only true and living God. We thank you, Lord, that you are, hallelujah, the Rose of Sharon. You are a mighty God. You're awesome in all your ways, God. There is none like you, God. Hallelujah. You are the beginning and the end, Lord. You're the author and the finisher of our faith. We thank you, Lord, that you are the bread of life. Hallelujah. We glorify the name of Jesus. Oh, God, for your name is a strong tower where the righteous runneth in and they are safe, God. Oh, God, we thank you, hallelujah, for this day. For this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you for new mercies on today. We thank you for your grace, God. Hallelujah, for every situation and every circumstance. Oh, God, you grace us up, God, in the name of Jesus to be victorious in all that we do, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, hallelujah, for the blood of Jesus. We thank you for the victory on the cross. We thank you, Lord, that you made us to be the righteousness of God in Christ. We thank you, Lord, hallelujah, that healing is the children's bread. Oh, God, we thank you for your peace, God, a peace which passes all understanding. We thank you, Lord, that we are the head and not the tail, above only and never beneath. Hallelujah, that we're more than conquerors, that we are overcomers in Christ Jesus. We thank you, Lord, that you're giving us, God. Hallelujah. Oh, God, the victory in Christ, God, that in him we live and move and have our being, God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. That we bless your holy name. We bless your name. That you're giving us your Holy Spirit, God. That will lead and guide us to all truth, God. Oh, God, we thank you, Lord, for your word, God. Every promise and every benefit, God, belongs to us, God. We thank you, Lord, that you're thinking about us, God. You say your thoughts of us are good and not evil. That will bring us into an expected end, God. That you never leave us or forsake us. And Lord, we just thank you on today. We thank you for your goodness, God. We thank you for your love, God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Oh, God, we thank you. Hallelujah. Oh, God, for new mercies every day, God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for the blood that covers our homes, God. The blood, God, that covers our property, God. The blood that covers our vehicles, God. Every mode of transportation that we take, God. The blood covers, God. Every stretch of road, God. Every airway, God. The blood covers, God. Oh, God, we pray, God. Hallelujah. Glory to God that the blood covers schools that our children attend, God. It covers the online learning, God. The blood covers our jobs, God. Our churches, God. The blood covers, God. Covers your people, God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for this power in the blood of the Lamb. There's power in your name, God. And we thank you, Lord, this day, God. Hallelujah. Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you. We bind you up and we render you powerless and out to nullify your power in the lives of God's people in the name of Jesus. That no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper, and every tongue that rises up against us in judgment shall be condemned. We bind up and we cancel every assignment, every plot, every scheme, every snare, and every trap of the enemy against us, our finances, our health, our children, our marriages, on our jobs, God. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, the blood is against you. We render you powerless and out to nullify your power in the name of Jesus. We break every supply line. We break every, oh God, every line of communication. We break it in the name of Jesus. The blood. Oh God, every spirit that will keep us bound. Every spirit. Hallelujah. We bind it up right now in the name of Jesus. The blood, every spirit of sickness and poverty, lack and debt, not enough, just enough. We bind you up, Satan. The blood. And we loose, hallelujah, the prosperity of God into our lives. We loose good health. Oh, God, we pray that we have long life and good health. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, the blood. We bind up COVID-19 out of every household that's listening right now, God, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord, for the blood. We thank you for the victory, God. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God that you made us to be more than conquerors, God. In the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah for your precious Holy Spirit. And Lord, we thank you, Lord, and we just give you praise, God. We give you honor. We give you glory, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Oh, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for a praise that's down on the inside, God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. We thank you to be grateful, God. Hallelujah. Thank you for what you've done. Thank you for what you're doing. And Lord, we give you a yet praise for what you're going to do. In Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Oh God, we want to continue our study in the Holy Spirit. And we're going to probably take it to the end of the month. We're going to talk about Shine the Light, part two. Amen. We are continuing our lesson. And then we want, you know, Paul talked about that he prayed that our hearts would be open to the wisdom of God. And then we went over where David prayed that the word of God would be hidden in our hearts, and that he prayed also that our eyes will be open to the word of God. And so we need our hearts to be softened to the word of God. So when the Holy Spirit speaks to us, that he can, that we'll be obedient to the word of God. And it's softened enough that we will take heed to the wisdom of the Holy Spirit. And then David wants us to hide the word in our hearts so we won't sin against God. That as again, we can hear and have conviction through the Holy Spirit. And then he wants our eyes to be open unto the word of God, that it doesn't become old or stale to us. Because God, you know, in the scriptures, you can read it one way, and then next week you read another way, and you'll get something different because it's a living word. And so he wants us to have that aha moment to understand the depth of God's love for us. And so we want to continue on through the power of the Holy Ghost, to have the Holy Ghost continually working in our lives, not to receive it as salvation and just sit it aside, but the Holy Ghost, it was so powerful that we need the Holy Ghost to grow in the knowledge and wisdom of God. We want to go to 2 Peter 1 and 3. And then, and you know, God reveals his word. We have his word before us. His word, you know, everything we need is right here in his word. But we have, this is like his word versus our understanding. Because, you know, when we don't have a right understanding, we can interpret things the way we want to interpret and make it fit the way we want to fit. But no, we got to interpret it. That's why the job of the Holy Spirit is, as God reveals his word, the mystery of his word to his people, he gives us the understanding God wants us to have. And that's the job of the Holy Spirit. The truth has already been revealed. How we live it out and apply it, it makes a difference every day. That's an everyday difference. It makes a difference in our lives that we have to apply the word of God. So often that we hear, just hear the word of God, but we need the wisdom of the Holy Spirit to apply, how to apply that word. How to apply that word in different situations, different circumstances. As I said, last week, we can apply it. I can apply this, the same scripture, you know, one way this week. Next week, God may give me another direction how to apply it. Next year, something else. It all depends on what we're going through. And so we have to have the wisdom of the Holy Spirit on how to apply the word of God. Wisdom, hallelujah, on how to apply the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's go to John 16 and 13. Amen. Amen. We all need wisdom. Wisdom is something that you never don't, you know, something that, okay, I don't need no wisdom. Yeah, we need wisdom every day. We need wisdom on how to deal with our spouses. We need wisdom on how to deal with our children. One thing I learned, I have adult children now. But, you know, when you just have little children, God gives you wisdom how to deal with your infants and your babies. And then, but you have to learn. You don't just learn how to deal with children, you know, of your parent of little kids. And then, you know, if an adult kid comes into your life, you got to learn. You got to have wisdom how to deal with them because they're going through different things. And so you have to, you know, you have to grow and you learn wisdom as your children grow older. And so all my children are adult children, so I've learned how to deal with my children as adults. I have one son that's married. I don't totally get in their stuff if they ask me to, But, you know, I've never been a busybody in-law. Now, if you ask me a question, you may want to hear my answer or not. But even the other two that's not married, but they're single. And so there are, things that I would give them, but I try not to still be in their business. But now, they ask them, they may tell you a different story. But that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Amen. Amen. So let's go to John 16 and 13. Howbeit when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth, for he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine, and shall show it to unto you. Now, the Holy Spirit will give you insight and illuminate what you already know, the already revealed word. God doesn't keep anything from us as his children. Now, it's a mystery to them that don't know him. But God, through the power of the Holy Spirit, his children, that those that accept him as Lord and Savior, those are the ones that receive the Holy Spirit. So he gives us the insight and illuminate, shine that word. He shines the word so that we can get an understanding of his word, the understanding he wants us to have. And then the Holy Spirit, being God all by himself, works in unison with God the Father and Jesus the Son. They work together. The three are one, the Godhead. They work together so good that the Holy Spirit, he don't have no thought. He don't have no thought. He just, if God said it, that's it. That's it. He don't say, well, God said this script, God said this, but I don't think it should be that. I think it should be that. Well, we're going to do it. No, they work in unison as one. And we, when we, the Bible says, we have the mind of Christ. We have to work as unison in Jesus. It's Jesus all day long. Nothing but Jesus. In him we live and have our, in him we move and have our being. We have to get to that point that our minds have to be renewed to have the wisdom of God through the Holy Spirit, that all that we do, everything points back to God in our lives. That he has to get the glory out of everything. We have to work in unison. But our minds got to be renewed to do that. Amen. Amen. The Holy Spirit will talk to you. And he will talk to us and give us directions. God works. He'll work through dreams. He'll work through just, talking to us. And the thing about this is that God just, he's so sovereign. He don't just have to talk to believers and give believers dreams. But the thing about it is that regardless of what we say and unsay, we have to do it to the best obedience that we can. We have to walk it out to the obedience, because we can't do anything contrary to God's word. So, and then sometimes we may get it wrong because we're in this flesh. We don't get it right all the time. We may get it wrong at times. Amen. But as God gives us and wants us to have the illumination, wants our eyes to be open and our hearts to be open, it doesn't always happen, because there's sin in our lives that prevent the light from going on, that we can't see the light. We can't see it always. Let's go to 1 Corinthians 3 and 1. Amen. Hallelujah. Let the light shine. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. It was a song, I think, it was a secular group that said, heaven. You had the song that say, let the light shine. I can't remember who it was. I don't think it was Earth, Wind & Fire. It's not Earth, Wind & Fire. I can't remember. But praise God. There's a lot of lights. But the only true light is the light of the living God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So Paul is saying here, he's saying, and I, brethren, could not speak unto you as unto spiritual, but as unto carnal, even as to babes in Christ. I have fed you with milk and not with meat. For hitherto ye were not able to bear it, neither yet now are ye able. You know, there are a lot of things that God probably wants to say to us. But if we're not spiritually mature enough to receive it, and we got sin on in our lives, and we're embracing another lifestyle other than holiness, God is not able to penetrate our hearts. He's not able to open up our eyes so that he can see it because we're not mature enough in him. It's, you know, there are things that, I have a 9-year-old grandson. And so there are things that I can't tell him about calculus. But then if I had a math major and all of a sudden he forgot the things of calculus, there would be a problem. But the thing is that a lot of times we regress because of the decisions that we make. So because of the decisions that we make, it causes us to regress, and it causes us not to hear what God wants to tell us. And we remain stuck. And we wonder why we can't get from A to B. Because we got stuff in a way that God cannot illuminate because of decisions that we made, because we're not mature enough to handle. But because Paul said, he said, we're too carnal. We're too carnal. He said, our brother could not speak unto you as unto somebody spiritual. You're not mature enough. You still need milk. I need to feed you meat, but you still need milk. You still need milk. You can't chew. Your body isn't strong enough to absorb it. Your teeth are not strong enough to chew. And I have fed you with milk and not with meat. But hitherto you were not able to bear, and neither yet now are ye. You still ain't able to do it. You're still not able to. So we have to get to a place where we can reach maturity and make decisions that are good for our spiritual growth. Because we want to know more about God. We don't always want to just stay in the surface. You just don't always want to stay on the surface. You know, there were times when I loved to go into by the water. Love to sit by the water. Love everything about, you know, looking at the water, lakes and rivers and the oceans and stuff. I don't know how to swim, so I'm not going too deep. At Bound the Beach, I'm not going too deep in the water. I'm just going to stay on the sand where the waves come and just wash my feet because I don't know how to swim. So I'm going to stay on the surface. So, but God don't want us to always stay on the surface. He wants us to get into the deep things of God. Getting to know him and having that deep relationship with him. Nobody just wants the surface of the stuff. We want the meat of something. We want the meat of it. You know, just like eating a piece of chicken or whatever. You just don't want the skin all the time. You want to taste the meat of it. You want to enjoy it. So we have to get off the surface. Just stop, the shadow of stuff. But enjoy a deep relationship with God. Then you can talk to him and he can talk to you. And you can see, like I said, that these words come off the page. They become life unto you. Life unto you. And a lot of times we want God to tell us something. You know, we're praying, or even God can tell us something. And so we want clarity. God, what do you mean by this? I need clarity of that. I need understanding. But a lot of times God just wants to say, clean your mess up. Just clean your mess up and then you can understand. Clean up everything that's holding you back. Clean up everything that's hindering you. Clean it up. Clean it up. Clean our lives up. We keep praying and we're praying and we're not getting an answer. Not that God not that he can't answer, he won't answer, he has not answered. But we got to be able to hear. But it's too much stuff in our lives that we won't allow the Holy Spirit to convict us of, to clean up. Clean up. Clean my heart, God. Take out everything in me that's not like you, God. Wash me in your word, God. Wash me, God. That I can hear that your word can become illuminated in my life. Amen. That it can shine. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because illuminated can be shut down by our mess. It can be shut shut, he can just shut it down. We can quench the Holy Spirit when we're not right. We can grieve the Holy Spirit because God wants so much more for us. He gave his only begotten son. He laid everything out from the beginning of the world. But it's up to us. We, you know, we got a free will that works for us, and sometimes it can work against us by the decisions that we make. Amen. We don't want to continue to always regress. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Let's go to 1 John 1. Hallelujah. 1 John 1. Amen. To illuminate our way, to be, you know, a light unto our feet, a light unto our pathway. You know, the word of God, we need the word of God. There's so much going on. We need his word for comfort. We need his word for peace. We need his word. Like we want to know, we cannot have, you know, we want to cherry pick our certain scriptures when we go through certain things. We don't want, but we know, Lord, God, I don't want to hear about what you got to say about nothing else. It's just about me. No, it's still about God. It's still about his plan and his purpose. It's still about that. But the wonderful thing about God is though even this is still his plan, his purpose, but it's a blessing in it for us. His grace is sufficient for us in every situation. Every circumstance, everything that we go through, his grace is sufficient. He's, even though if you point back to him, everything you go through, God should still get the glory out of it. But because you're going to end up being blessed. He just blesses his people because he just loves us. Hallelujah. 1 John 1, 6-7. Amen. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus, hallelujah, Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin. We can't say that we have fellowship with God and just do what we want to do. But when we see Christ, we receive his spirit. So we have the capacity to have wisdom in how to apply his word. The Spirit changes the way we think. The Holy Spirit changes the way we think. So we can't say that I got the Holy Ghost. You know, I'm speaking and you're speaking in tongues on Sunday and you're cussing somebody else at work on Monday. No. It changes the way you think. It convicts you. It causes you to walk in the light. It causes you to walk in the light. We have, because what it says that if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another in the blood of Jesus, his son, cleanses us from all sin. The blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sin. We have to have faith in that. We have to believe by faith that we've been cleansed. But the Holy Ghost, because we're still in his flesh, but the Holy Ghost gives a spirit of conviction. The Holy Ghost gives us the wisdom on how to apply the word of God. The Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Oh God, because when the trouble comes, when the test comes, when the trial comes, when the temptation comes, that's why we have the word of God in our lives, in our heart. Because when those things come, we have to be reminded, Lord, that I can count it all joy. I can count it all joy. And that he's an ever-present help in the time of trouble. That he's there. He's ever-present. He's right there. I don't have to wait for him. He's right there in the trouble. And then he's made a way out of escape that I'll be able to bear it. He won't put on us no more than we can bear. He's made a way out of escape. So when we have the word in our hearts, we open up our eyes to know that God is there. That we meditate on the word of God day and night. We're thinking about the word of God. We're feasting on the word of God. So when trouble comes, testing comes, that the Holy Ghost got something on the inside. Hallelujah. Glory to God to grab hold to. Hallelujah. Because the enemy wants you to be deprived. He wants that spirit man to be hungry. We don't deprive ourselves of food. I know I don't. We don't deprive ourselves of food. So we can't deprive ourselves of the Holy Ghost. I mean, of the Word of God. We need to build up our spirit man. My prayer is, Lord, you know, when I pray, I say, okay, Lord, strengthen my body and strengthen my spirit. I need my spirit man to be strengthened. But I can't say, excuse me, strengthen my spirit, and I ain't putting nothing in and I ain't feeding it. So we got to have, we got to feast on the Word of God. We got to take time. We take time for everything else. We take time for foolishness. We take time to go out to dinner. We take time to watch TV, to go to the movies, to go bowling. All that stuff is open right now. To get our nails done, our hair done. Our souls need to be worth it. Our souls need to be worth it. That I just take time. Take time. I tell people, start in 15 minutes. Start, build yourself up. You know, build yourself up and keep going and keep going. Hallelujah, till you get, you know, to where you can have a nice, healthy appetite for the Word of God. You know, my son, when he first, he came back to the Lord and stuff, he started prayer. He said, Mama, I started 1 minute. I prayed for 1 minute. Then I went to 2 minutes. Then I went to 3 minutes and 4 minutes. I thought that was kind of crazy, but you know what? It's not. But it gave him a steady diet. He kept adding on. He was faithful till he got up to that hour and possibly even more. You know, but you got to be focused. We got to be focused. God has to be, because all that he's done for us, he's got to be worth it. It's got to be worth it. You got to be worth it. You know, it's this thing about self-care and it's about self-investment. Invest in your spirit, man. Invest in your spirit, man. Because when the enemy comes, he's going to come and tear you down. He's going to come and tell you what you ain't, who you ain't, what you ain't got, what you don't have. Invest in who God has made you to be. Know who you are in Christ Jesus. Know who you are. Know what God has done for you. So then when the enemy comes, he can't find nothing. Oh, Lord, she done built herself up. Look, she thinks she's something. Yeah, I am. I am more than a conqueror. I'm an overcomer. I am the righteousness of God in Christ. I know who I am. I am victorious. Yes, I do. You don't know, devil? Mm-mm. Nope. My spirit man is strong. My spirit man, he's strong. He's lifting weights, taking his protein. He's doing whatever, everything he needs to do. We got to get to that point. And you may not be at that point, but a little time, add it on. Know that you're worthy, that God made you worthy. You're not worthy in yourself, but because of Jesus, he has made you worthy. And you know that you're worth the investment, spiritual investment. And one thing I love about God, that when he blesses you spiritually, it overflows into your natural. It overflows that. And next thing you know, you'll be going and people will just be running after you to bless you. There'll be favor will go before you and surround you as a hedge. Oh God, thank you, Lord, that the grace of God, hallelujah, be sufficient in everything in your life that you're going through. Every problem, every trouble, hallelujah, your family, your kids, glory to God. Just put the word on them. You have enough word in you that you can put the word in them. Amen. The Holy Spirit brings conviction and you hear his voice and the voice of a stranger will not follow. You hear his voice. That's a good thing. Hallelujah. That's a good thing to know the voice of the Holy Spirit. To know that he will keep you from harm and he will keep you from danger because he'll guide you into all truth. And sometimes truth is not the best, not we want. We don't always want to hear truth. And we don't, you know, but truth is better than a lie. It's better than a lie. Because the truth will eventually make you safe and secure. Amen. You just have to embrace the truth of God's word. Amen. So the Holy Spirit cannot illuminate what's not there. If you ain't got no word in you, what are you gonna illuminate? Ain't nothing there. And I can grieve the Holy Spirit because he wants to do what he wants. He wants to do for you, but he can't because there's nothing there. There's no word there. And so you get stuck. You keep going through over and over the same thing. You know what? We gotta get tired of going through the same thing over and over again. Stop doing the same thing over and over again, repenting for the same thing. Because you keep doing it over again, you really, there's no repentance. You just sorry that you keep going over it. You want right, but then we cannot just keep doing the same thing over and over again and expecting deliverance. Amen. We can't. We can't expect deliverance. But God is the grace of God and sovereign, and he can deliver you if you choose to. Amen. Amen. And so, as we feed the Holy Spirit, we can ask for wisdom. And God say, ask for wisdom, he'll give it to us liberally. We feed the Holy Spirit, we have a good appetite, then God will lead and guide us as to where we have to go. He'll give us everything that we need, hallelujah, for the journey. He'll give us what we need for the journey. Amen. Because sometimes, you know, our journey gonna take us to places that we've never been before. Our journey, hallelujah, we're going to go through some stuff we've never gone through before, because it's life. Life will take you on right turns and left turns. But, you know, but we have to do what God has called us to do. Amen. So the Holy Spirit will lead and guide us to give us the understanding as what we need for our journey. But, you know, but he gives us conviction about even our own junk. He gives us conviction. You know, we always want the Holy Ghost or the Word to tell us about somebody else. No, he gives us conviction about our own stuff. He tells us about our own attitudes. He tells us about where we need to forgive. He tells us about what, you know, what we need to do. And, you know, and so we have, you know, the Holy Spirit. We want God to bless us with finances, but we ain't paying no tithes. Holy Spirit let you know, okay, you need to give. You need to pay tithes. You need to sow seed. And stop trying to receive all the time. So the Holy Spirit, you know, give us an understanding even about that, how to love. You know, so God, and to know the discernment, to know truth, that you won't be subject to every wave of doctrine that comes by. That you will know the word of God when it's being taught. You know, so the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, is our helper. He's our helper. And then the Holy Spirit is a weapon in your prayer life. You know, he will teach you how to pray. He will have you pray for people. He will word your mouth on what to pray. And we haven't even got to like the speaking in tongues. You know, that builds up your spirit, man. So the Holy Spirit will cause you to have a better prayer life. Amen. You know, because as I said before, prayer is the way we communicate with God. It tells God to come into our situation. It tells God, it gives God the authority to come into what's going down here on the earth realm. And so we need that prayer, because God is not going to come, because he gave us dominion over this earth. He gave us dominion. That's how he set it up. So he has to come in. He's sovereign, as I said. He can do whatever he wants to do, but he can't go against his word, because he gave us dominion over this earth. So we, when some situation, circumstances come, we have to pray and ask God to intervene. And then the Holy Spirit, in some places that your light is only lighting around, because there's so much darkness in our family, there's so much darkness on our jobs and where we are. Our light is sometimes the only light to shine. And then there's times when your light is competing with smaller lights from people that are other doctrines, you know, that are teaching other doctrines, and that's who they're serving to other gods. So your light is competing with smaller lights. The Bible said, let your light so shine that men will see your good works and glorify who? Your heavenly Father. Amen. Amen. And so let's go to one more scripture, our last scripture on Romans 8:14. God is a good God, and he's worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Hallelujah. Bless your name. Bless your name, Lord. Bless your mighty name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to your name, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. So Romans 8:14 says, for as many are as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Man, this separates the believer from the non-believer. For many that are led by the Spirit of God, that are led by the Holy Spirit, we are the sons of God, the daughters of God. We are his children, that he gives his Spirit to his children. Just like my children, they got our last name, Walker. We don't, you know, they didn't get nobody else's last name. So we got God's Spirit, his children. We are believers. We have to be excited that the God of the universe speaks to us through his word, because we're his children. He gives us the Holy Spirit to understand what he is, the revealed word of God, what he is already, what we should already know. Every scripture that comes, that we should hear, he gives us the understanding. He gives us a wisdom on how to apply it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And you know, the wonderful thing about it is that the Holy Spirit is the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead. How awesome is that? How awesome is that? Me and you got the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead. My God. Resurrection power. Glory to God. Glory to you. He can't give you wisdom on how to go through your little stuff. He can't give you wisdom on how to apply the word of God to your life, to change your mind, to change the way you think, to change the way you talk, change where you go, how you walk. Come on now. Come on now. No. The Holy Spirit, he dwells in us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm excited about the Holy Ghost. I'm excited. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, God, to feast on God's word, to use his word, hallelujah, in everything that comes up, hallelujah, that God will get the glory, regardless of how it feels, what I got to go through. I know that God's going to get the glory, hallelujah, that all things work together for them who love God and they call according to his purpose, hallelujah, glory to God, his purpose that he has for us. God will get the glory. Everything has to point back to God. Everything has to point back to his word, his glory, his power. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God is good. And we serve a mighty God. And Father God, we thank you, Lord, as we go through this series of the Holy Spirit, that we will learn more about you, God. That we will go into the deep, God. And then we seek your face, God. That we will feast on your word and have a greater appetite for your word, God. As we have a greater appetite for your word, God, that you will illuminate the word, God, for us, God. Hallelujah. That we will know you. Hallelujah. In another way, God. That we will know you. Hallelujah. Glory to God in a greater relationship. That we will know you as we love our brothers and sisters. And we walk in forgiveness, God. And as we walk in forgiveness, God, that we walk in a repentant spirit, God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, God, that we can be used like you, used by you, God. Oh, God, and to know who we are in Christ Jesus and to know who you are. We thank you on today, God, and we bless your name, Lord, and we give you glory, give you honor in the name of Jesus. Now, if you don't know Christ, the Bible, hallelujah, says that in Romans 10:9-10, that if you believe with your heart and confess with your mouth, you shall be saved. And all you have to do is repeat after me. Father, in Jesus' name, I accept Jesus as my Savior. By confession, with my mouth, hallelujah, glory to God, the Lord Jesus, and believe in my heart that you should, that you, hallelujah, raised him from the dead for my sins and the sins of the world. Oh, God, thank you, Father. Hallelujah, for changing my heart, changing my mind, changing my will, changing my emotions. Hallelujah. Oh, God, give me the power through your precious Holy Spirit to live a life that's pleasing to you and that will draw others into the kingdom of God. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, amen. Until next time. Hallelujah. We walk by faith and not by sight. Amen.